disorders at Fortis CDOC Hospital in Nehru Place. And today I want to talk about something which we don't talk about enough. We don't talk about often, and that is sexual dysfunction in men. It's a very common problem, very common complaint which people have. But many a times patients are not very clear as to where they need to go, whether they should consult, whether they should take a professional advice at all, or if so, where should they go? Should they go to a psychologist, a psychiatrist? Should they just ask their friend? And also, there are so many inhibitions, as we are all aware, that sometimes it is associated with, it is seen to be associated with strength and all, and going to a specialist might seem that the person is some kind of weak and all. So all that we need to understand, that when should we consult, and what are the causes, and what exactly is this? Now, it's a very common problem, sexual dysfunction in men, and there are various kinds of problems. So when we say sexual dysfunction, it could be many things. It could be reduction in the sexual desire, libido. The person doesn't feel like engaging in sexual activity. Or it could be a problem in getting an erection, so-called erectile dysfunction, where erection is not strong enough or hard enough or it doesn't sustain long enough for sexual intercourse to happen. Or there could be problems in ejaculation. A very common issue is premature ejaculation, but sometimes there could be delayed ejaculation. And there are some other issues as well. So what are these problems? Now, these problems are multifactorial. The causes are too many. It could simply be stress, as we all know. Stress can cause sexual dysfunction. But there could be some other disorders which can lead to that. The blood flow may not be proper. There may be problem in blood flow to the penis, and that might result in a poor erection. Erection doesn't become hard enough. Or there could be problem with hormones. Hormones, the male hormone, testosterone, which is secreted by testes. Now, that may be deficient due to several reasons. It could be a trauma to the testes. It could be an infection of the testes in childhood or later on. Or it could be without any reason. It just happens that sometimes the testosterone gets low without any reason, just like any other thyroid disorder, any other hormonal disorder like thyroid, etc., where there is no discernible reason, but it just happens. Or it's not just testosterone. There are many other hormones. There are hormones produced by a gland called pituitary, which is situated in the brain. And that those hormonal disorders can also cause problems in erection and sexual desire. So, and also, sometimes the nerves get involved because of several reasons, because of diabetes, because of alcohol, because of many other things, old age. The nerves get affected, and that leads to a problem in erection and other things. There are several drugs which can cause problem in erection. Several drugs which can lower the desire. It can impair the erection. It can even impair the ejaculation. So all those things we need to see if we have these kind of problems. But why do these occur? These are the mechanisms. So why do these occur? The most important preventable reason, so-called preventable reason, to some extent, is being overweight or obese. So if the weight gain is there, if the person gains a lot of weight, there is a chance that the hormones come down, the blood flow, there is a problem in the blood flow, and there is a problem consequently in erection and even sexual desire. So the weight gain is one major reason for this problem. The other important reason is diabetes. Diabetes can sometimes lead to this problem. In fact, it's very common in people who have had diabetes for long. So that is another thing which we need to see. High blood pressure, high blood cholesterol, heart disease, all these things can impair sexual function. Then there are other reasons as well. There are other specific disorders of hormones, of male hormones. There are some genetic disorders. There are other infections, etc., which can impair sexual function. after surgery, after prostate surgery especially, or after a pelvic surgery, the nerves can get impaired, the blood supply can get impaired, and that can impair the sexual function. One very important reason for impaired erection is smoking. Smoking can lead to direct damage and can cause impotence. Alcohol also can cause problems by various means. Alcohol causes problems in the nerves. The nerves get damaged. The internal nerves which are there, they can get damaged. And that leads to problem in erection. Also, liver disease can cause problem. If there is liver disease, the hormones which are produced, their metabolism gets affected, and that leads to sexual dysfunction. So there are so many reasons, as you can see, that which can impair sexual function. So if someone has a sexual problem, so it becomes imperative to consult a doctor, to consult a physician, who can then ask questions, what kind of sexual function problem is it? Is it erection which is a problem? Is it desire which is a problem? Is it ejaculation which is a problem? Or is it something else? Or is it simply stress? There is too much work, too much pressure, too much stress, which is leading to these problems. Or there could be problems in interpersonal relationship. So all these factors need to be assessed when one sees a patient with sexual dysfunction. So one needs to go to a doctor who will assess how serious is your problem and whether it needs further evaluation or not. Many a times, we would do some blood tests, and we'll do blood tests for hormones. We'll check a basic hormone called testosterone. And depending on its results, one can then see if we need to do further tests, if we need to do any other hormones which could be abnormal. And depending on that, the treatment can be instituted. But apart from hormones, there are so many other reasons for this. So one may need to do other tests. One may need to test sugar. One may need to test thyroid, cholesterol, liver function. All these things need to be checked, and they are important if we want to assess a person with erectile dysfunction. Also, erectile dysfunction and sexual dysfunction, we know we want to treat because it causes problem in life and personal relationship. But also important is the fact that erectile dysfunction in a man could be a harbinger of heart disease. Many people with heart disease would develop erectile dysfunction before they develop heart disease. So if there is erectile dysfunction which is developing in a person, one needs to assess whether one is not at risk for heart disease. So that is an important facet. So if there is erectile dysfunction, one needs to assess the risk of heart disease by assessing sugar, by assessing cholesterol, by assessing family history of heart disease, by seeing if the person is smoking or not. So all those factors need to be assessed. And if something is found, then one needs to take corrective measures. So what's the treatment? Now, the most important treatment is lifestyle, as in any other lifestyle disease. So diet, exercise is very important. Eat healthy, exercise regularly, lose weight. When I say eat healthy, there is no specific food which increases libido scientifically. There is no aphrodisiac food. But just as you take healthy diet for diabetes or heart disease or cholesterol, in the same way you take healthy diet for sexual dysfunction also. The same diet works here as well. So eat less, reduce calories if you're eating too much, increase protein, reduce carbohydrates, reduce fat, take healthy fat, take lots of fruits and vegetables. So all that helps in your metabolism, in your blood flow, and that can improve erection. Also, exercise is important. It has been shown that exercise can even improve not just the blood flow, but also the male hormones. The testosterone can get improved with regular exercise. And then there are certain medicines which can be given. And there are very effective medicines which can be given, which are safe, but they need to be used with proper medical advice, because otherwise they can be problems. There are certain kinds of patients in whom one may need to be extra cautious before prescribing those medicines. So please do not do not treat yourself and seek medical advice if you have any such issues. And as I said, apart from treating erectile dysfunction or sexual dysfunction, one also needs to look at the risk of heart disease and manage accordingly. Now, sometimes the hormones are not okay. The hormones are haywire. And in that case, again, one may need hormone therapy. But remember, hormone therapy is a highly, highly specialized therapy in the treatment of sexual dysfunction and needs expert advice. So do not take testosterone just like that. In fact, it can do more harm than good if it is not monitored properly, if it is not done in a proper way. So it is far too complex to be taken lightly. So very important to seek medical advice before taking testosterone. Now, what about young people who go to the gym? Very good to go to the gym. We want people to go to the gym and exercise. But many a times in the hurry to build muscles, people take androgens, testosterone, or anabolic steroids. Now, these things do build muscles, but they can actually suppress your own testosterone production, and one may end up with sexual dysfunction later on after some time. So please be very careful. Do not indulge in such practices. Those muscles are not going to do you any good. They are in fact going to be detrimental in the long run. And you may develop testosterone deficiency later on, which may be a little difficult to treat. So be scientific, try to exercise regularly, do resistance exercise, do a lot of exercise. You can take protein supplements, but do not take any androgens or anabolic steroids. So this is how we need to assess erectile dysfunction and sexual dysfunction. And in case there is any other major disorder found, that can also be detected if you seek medical advice. So I think this is what we need to understand. And if there are any questions, we'll be very happy to take them. Thank you. Okay, so we have one question. Can hormonal issues be linked with two sexual problems? Yeah. So hormonal issues, yes, can be linked to sexual problems. But at the same time, not every sexual problem has a hormonal issue. So please remember, majority of the people who have sexual dysfunction do not have any hormonal problem. They may have simply some psychological issues. They may have some relationship issues or stress. On the other hand, some of them would have hormonal dysfunction. And that hormonal dysfunction needs to be first evaluated and treated. So you needs to get some tests done and some blood test, usually a blood test. And depending on the result of blood test, one needs to then plan therapy accordingly. Also to remember, in a young person who has not completed family, wants to have children, it's very important to be careful about taking testosterone, because testosterone cannot be given to people who have not had children and who are desirous of having fertility. Okay, so what are the top to help cure erectile dysfunction? Well, there are no top five things. Let me tell you, there are no top five things to eat. The key is to eat healthy. And when I say eat healthy, eat lots of fruits and vegetables, eat protein, which means if you're a vegetarian, eat dal, legumes, eat paneer, milk, milk products. If you're a non-vegetarian, you can have egg, you can have chicken and fish. Avoid red meat as far as possible. And have healthy fat. Healthy fat meaning like nuts, almonds, walnuts. All these things are healthy fat. So take that. Reduce saturated fat. So reduce outside food, reduce ghee, reduce butter, reduce all that. And also reduce calories. Very important in our context, Indians tend to consume a lot of calories. They eat a lot of carbohydrate. So we need to reduce that as well. So if we do that, we can hope to achieve a better blood flow, which will prevent erectile dysfunction, and also the testosterone might get boosted if we do follow these things. Okay, so erectile dysfunction most likely temporary or chronic? So I think the question is that whether it is temporary or it can it be long lasting. So it's both. Sometimes it is temporary. And there could be some stress. There could be some lot of weight gain, and that could impair the erectile performance. On the other hand, there are certain issues, certain diseases, which can actually impair blood flow, which can actually lower the testosterone levels, and that could be chronic, and that needs treatment. But important thing to realize is that most of the time it is treatable. In majority, a large majority of patients, we can treat this, and patient can have a healthy sex life. Okay, so what are the exercises to help reduce diabetes and sexual problems? So exercises, both aerobic as well as resistance. So when I say aerobic, I mean walking, running, jogging, cycling, swimming, playing tennis, playing badminton, playing anything. So that is aerobic exercise. So that needs to be done. So that is important, that increases your cardiovascular fitness, that increases your blood flow to everywhere in the body and also to your sex organs. So that improves erectile performance. Also, resistance exercises are also helpful. So resistance exercises means doing light weights. Even people who are not very young, who are old, and they feel that they don't have enough strength, even they should do. In fact, they should do more these resistance exercises with light weights. One can start with just small weights like 1 kg or 2 kgs and gradually build up. So all these exercises improve blood flow, improve testosterone, and can improve the sexual dysfunction. Okay, so can it be cured having psychological or stress problem in this? Okay, so there are sometimes psychological problems. That is there. That sometimes there is some kind of a psychiatric disorder like depression or something. Sometimes there could be some psychological issues like anxiety, like some phobia or something. Or there could be relationship issues. Or there could be simply stress at work, just not having enough time, always stressed. So all those things can impair sexual function. Believe me, most of the time, these problems can be tackled with proper counseling, with a therapist, talking to a therapist, talking to your doctor. These things can usually be managed successfully, and these things usually are not chronic. They are temporary and respond to treatment. The key thing is counseling and also a good partner as well. Okay, so I think we had a good session, and this problem, as I said, is important to understand and to assess. One should seek medical advice if there is something like that, so that further assessment can be done and a proper treatment can be given. Thank you.